I know how hard it is to talk about. I mean, to even say the word. Rape.
I know. And I wish I could talk to Jason, but he feels so guilty.
Even though it wasn't his fault.
Yeah.
Look, you can talk to me, Sam, okay?
Hey.
Hey. Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
Say that I'm sorry. About Abby.
Yeah, you think I'm gonna wake up out of this nightmare, but it's real. Abby's gone.
Is there anything I can do for you?
No, there's nothing anybody can do. It's fine.
Okay. Your mom got your message about the accident. I told her I'd call her and give her an update.
No, don't do that. You know Mom. She's just gonna try and fix things that can't be fixed. We need to arrange to have Abby's body released.
Michael.
Yeah.
You know anything you need. Anything.
I know. Thanks.
Jason, are you in Chicago with Michael?
Yeah, I just got here.
You have to come back. Someone tried to kill you.
Apparently, Sean went to a meeting in your place and...
Was anybody hurt?
Bernie. He was shot. He's in surgery now.
They're saying he's going to be fine. I tried calling Sonny, but I can't get a hold of him.
Okay, I'll take care of it.
Franco?
No, a business deal went south.
Jason, you should go home.
But you just got here.
There's nothing he can do, Sam. I mean, I'm just waiting for paperwork to take Abby's body home. But look, thanks for coming all this way and not telling Mom about Abby yet.
You asked me not to.
Well, I appreciate that. Well, I should get back to the business, okay? Sam, you should
go
with
him. No way, Michael. I'm not leaving you.
You need somebody to stay with you.
Look, I don't want to be a burden.
You're not. Come on. I'm... She's Abby's friend, too. I love her. Grieving together is not a burden.
I'll let you know that.
I know I should tell my mom. It's just going to be very hard to say.
Hey, no rush.
Everybody's telling me sorry, and the look on their faces, it just makes everything so real.
If you need help calling Abby's girlfriends, just give me the numbers, and I can help you with that.
Actually, I think I have some of their numbers.
What?
No, Abby gave me this date book right before it. Before we said goodbye for the last time. She filled it through 2012 with a bunch of dates of things we were gonna do together. All these dates you won't have, all these plans, I'm not gonna make. The only thing I'll be planning is her funeral. Abby was all about hope and faith. She once found this Native American saying, "Give thanks for unknown blessings already on their way." She taped it to her mirror.
That sounds like her. She was always so focused on positive and good.
No, she was a ballet dancer. You know that modern dance.
Yeah, I know. I do know that. She told me. Yeah, she actually told me she wanted to get back into it.
Yeah, she just signed up for night classes. That is so wrong. How anyone could say that it was God's plan is full of it. God would never want someone like Abby to leave this world.
She was happy with you.
We had so many places we wanted to go, so many things we wanted to do. Yeah. Abby was always so curious about everything. She was so open-minded about people. She, used to look through magazines and point out these places
She's really excited about possibly going there someday, and I should have taken her. I should have gotten a plane with her and just took off. And when I think about all the time we wasted.
You didn't waste any time. I don't think Abby would take back 1 second that she spent with you.
She had so many dreams. Say goodbye.
On one goodbye.